Erica and Tim, good morning. New at 11 o'clock, we are joined by the Lieutenant Governor this morning. Lieutenant Governor, you are here in Bristol talking about concerns over flooding in the wake of this storm. What is the picture you're seeing and what is the message you're trying to get out?
Well, we are seeing water levels increasing in rivers and streams across the state, just like this Pequabic River behind us. And our message to the people of Connecticut is please do not drive through standing water. Please beware of flooding, particularly in urban areas, because we've had so much rain. And also, we know tomorrow it's going to be warm, and we want people to avoid swimming in places where water is running like this. It's not just fast water that's a concern, but it's bacteria that is in our waterways because of sewage runoff. Our sewage systems have just been overwhelmed.
Lieutenant Governor, we heard some tough talk from your administration, you and the governor, when it came to Eversource and his utilities and how they would execute. The storm has largely passed. Are you ready to give them a grade? How have they done?
You know, I have to say that we dodged a bullet. We did not have the direct hurricane hit that we thought. And I would say that the utility companies have been very responsive, particularly with Eversource. Mayors and first selectmen have reported to the governor and I yesterday and today that municipal liaisons were on the ground helping out, and Eversource was prepared with utility trucks and prepared. We still have about 8,000 homes without power in Eversource territory and another 1,000 homes or so out of power on Avon grid. So we are hoping by the end of today or early tomorrow, those homes will have their power back on.
Lieutenant Governor, appreciate your time. We are also joined by Brian Foley with Emergency Services. You know Brian well in the morning show. Brian, you folks, we all saw this tragedy on the Farmington River earlier this summer with two young people who lost their lives in conditions similar to what we're seeing behind us now. You folks are taking action. You are prepared if something were to happen.
Oh, yeah. Well, look, that was a tragic situation, and the first responders in Farmington got there and did everything they could. Unfortunately, they weren't able to make a rescue. But with that, obviously, rivers and any swift water is not the place for anyone to go swimming, especially with the hot days coming. There's going to be a lot of fast-moving water. That being said, the governor, lieutenant governor, and Commissioner Rivella have staged the urban search and rescue team and the swift water rescue team at Brainerd in Hartford, centrally located and ready to respond. There's a full activation. The Emergency Operations Center. The command staff's been planning for this for several days, and we hope for it to be an overestimation of what damage and what danger there could be. That being said, we're prepared to respond to anything. And to give you some idea, Keith, of how it works, if something happens in a town like with Manchester last night, where you saw them evacuating a hotel with standing water coming up, the local fire departments, local police departments are very good at handling that. Should they become overwhelmed, should it become more, should they need additional resources, they reach out to the regional coordinators, and that's when the Division of Emergency Management will provide additional resources all the way up to the Connecticut National Guard and beyond, depending on how big and serious it gets. We certainly hope it doesn't get to that, but like the Lieutenant Governor said, everyone just kind of try not to be the problem, stay home, don't drive through standing water, and let the first responders do what they do should there be any flooding in your area.
And put your dad hat on as we take a look at conditions here. I mean, they're not awful, but they could be better. Young people are magnetically drawn sometimes to scenes like this.
So in Hartford, we would actually send the Marine Patrol out on the hot days, especially when the water was moving fast, just to patrol the rivers. And obviously, the local police departments and local fire departments know where the dangers are and where the swim holes are and where the kids are going to be. And we patrol during those times just to keep kids out of those dangerous areas. So, yeah, you don't want your kids messing around there.
And then just lastly, an update to the breaking news we saw yesterday on our show. Hundreds of cars backed up on 91 in Hartford. Yep. What happened there, and what's the cautionary warning for drivers?
So highways drain very well in the state of Connecticut. Very rarely do you see standing water in the state. That being said, that area of 91 has been chewed up for a while for ongoing construction, which is great that the construction's happening. However, the system was overwhelmed with water. The contractor was contacted to assist, but the Connecticut DOT brought out those industrial pumps, got the highway cleared. The heavy equipment was there within minutes to get the debris out of the roadway, and it's a good example. Once that water cleared, you saw the rocks and you saw the chunks of debris in there that you certainly don't want to be driving over, that people were, and that was causing accidents. So stay off the road. roads. Again, there's first responders that need to do their job. They don't want to respond to people not acting so smart.
Brian Foley with Emergency Management. Our thanks to the Lieutenant Governor for joining us as well. A lot of ground being covered here this morning. Of course, we'll have more throughout the day across all of our platforms and the Fox 61 News at 4 and 5. But for now, Tim and Erica in Bristol, I'm Keith McGilvery, Fox 61 News.
Actually, Keith, while we have you, do you want to talk just about concerns about water quality as well as just water quantity? What have you learned over the course of the morning about that?
Yeah, so Tim, the concern there from deep was that with all of this water that we have seen, that sewage, untreated sewage, could potentially leak into waterways large and small across the state of Connecticut. So really the message here at this point is if you're in any community where those feeder pipelines, you want to stay out of the water the best you can for the next 72 hours. Testing will take place this week to make sure that conditions are safe, but that's everything from swimming to paddle boarding to fishing. Steer clear, says DEEP. Again, they're trying to prevent any of that overflow raw sewage that's getting its way potentially into our waterways to making folks sick. So take that as a sign of caution here to just stay away. I spoke with the folks from DEEP earlier this morning. They say testing will happen throughout the morning tomorrow. Sometimes results can take up to 24 hours, so we will follow up on that as well. But steer clear for a number of reasons, water quality and obviously what can also be just dangerous levels in general.